know, we had a dream 10 years ago. This guy had a dream to help millions of people find peace of mind through expressive arts and really play a role in not only empowering people to share their mental health stories, but use that as a vehicle to break down stigma, which seems to be a really important topic here. You know, for PeaceLove, we started a program called Creators about 3.5 years ago. And the Creators program empowers frontline professionals, human service workers, teachers, social workers, mental health professionals, clinicians, to take expressive arts as a tool and use that to help their communities not only find peace of mind, but really empower them to talk about mental health in safe, celebratory ways. So we create safe spaces. We give people a tool in expressive arts that, you know, we believe is can be life-changing. Jeff is living proof of that. So it's been really inspiring to be here for a few days and hear creativity being used as a non-traditional therapy for mental health and wellness. With companies like Johnson & Johnson and the Wellcome Trust and the other folks that we've met here, they have the ability to help organizations like us really scale our programs and reach not only millions of people, but billions of people some days.
Known these guys really since the inception of the organization and saw it from really the seed in which Jeff was using painting for his own peace of mind creation. Saw it firsthand when he was then bringing it back to the community. What's most exciting for me is that as I saw Jeff speak last night and the others that were on the stage with Johnson & Johnson, as Matt mentions, the Welcome Fund, is that mental health has risen up to the upper echelons and the platform here as far as key topics. To me, that's exciting as much for the future as it is for this week.
Certainly, I think that the stigma surrounding mental health is maybe that last great social injustice that we have. And, you know, people ask me over the all these years, you know, why haven't we made the kind of progress that we need to on what I consider to be such an important issue? My answer has always been the same, invisible and misunderstood. You know, how do you take on, you know, something that you can't see and in many cases you don't even understand? And as a societal thing that we're not even willing to talk about in many cases. So to see our work and you know, appear on this type of stage in Davos with the support of people like Johnson & Johnson is obviously a very proud moment, but inspiring and hopeful that, you know, we've said all along it would take the J&Js of the world and the Wellcome Trust of the world to get behind organizations like ours. It's taken 10 years to build up something. We always like to say you can't reverse engineer authenticity. And we've built that, and I think it's finally arrived on the stage that it needs to, and we'll go home, you know, feeling very hopeful for